Good morning, students. In today's class of retail management, we'll recap all the topics that we have studied in the past, the online classes. The reason being that we are having an internal examination for which we want that all the topics that we have studied till now should be refreshed in our memory. So we'll start with retailing. What is retailing? The word retail has been derived from the French word retailer, which means to cut a piece off or to break the bulk. According to Philip Kotler, retailing includes all the activities in selling of goods or services to the final consumers for personal and non-business use. So there are two major characteristics that is coming under retailing. So all those activities that is done in the selling of goods and services, but it should be done to the final consumer and for his personal and non-business use. That is known as retailing. Importance of retailing is that retailing saves the lifestyle of the people, retailing contributes to the economy, retailing dominates the supply chain because here the retailer plays a main role in the supply chain. Then retailing is interdisciplinary and retailing is also acknowledged as a subject area in its own right, and retailers enjoy a status as major employers because a lot of employment opportunities are generated in the retail sector. Then retailers are also the gatekeepers within the channel of distribution. So they form the bridge between the wholesalers and manufacturers and customers, and retailing has scope of expanding internationally. So these are the reasons why retail marketing is very, very important. And that is the reason that we are focusing our studies on retail marketing. Then comes, what are the functions of retailing or retailer? So what are the things that the retailer should do and to provide the best services to his customers? So first they will provide an assortment. Providing assortment means giving a combination large products from which the customers can buy as per his own selection, wide selection that is being provided to the customer, from which the customers can actually decide and purchase. Then comes breaking the bulk, because in retailer also provides advantage of breaking the bulk, because the customers do not want to buy a lot of quantity in large quantities and they only want to purchase in small quantities. So retailers break the bulk and provide the merchandise to the customers as per their requirement in small quantities. They also hold inventory. So this is also one of the major functions, because once the retailer does not hold an inventory, then the customers cannot purchase all the merchandise from the retailer, and the customer has to keep stock in his own house. So that is the reason if inventory is provided and company and the retail company or the outlet has holds inventory, then the customers can, as per their convenience, can buy in small amount and as per their requirements. So holding inventory is also one of the functions of retailer. Then comes providing service. A lot of services is provided by the retailers, like offering credit, home delivery, after sales service, and information regarding new products and services. So these things are also providing these services also one of the functions of the retailer. Then comes sorting. Retailer helps in sorting because it helps both the manufacturer and the customers, because the manufacturer wants to sell large quantities to small number of buyers, and the customers want to buy in small quantities from different manufacturers. So the retailer helps in sorting and tries to keep the balance between the manufacturers and demands of the manufacturer and demands of the consumer. Then comes the channel of communication. Retailer forms the channels of communication between the wholesaler and the manufacturer and the customers. So they maintain these channels of communication. They sometimes, so the retailer also provides the functions of transportation and advertising function to small manufacturers, because these small manufacturers will be overshadowed by these large manufacturers. So this is also one of the functions of the retailer, whereby it helps the small manufacturers. So these are the major reasons why the functions of a retailer. And then comes, what are the drivers of retail change in India? So there are certain drivers why the retail change in India is increasing in India. First is the rising income, then liberalizing, then spending power of the people is increasing, then the advent of dual income family or DINGS. Dual income means both husband and wife are working, and then there is a shift in consumer demand and consumer preferring more foreign brands like McDonald's, Sony, Panasonic, Samsung. So these are the reasons why there is a demand for retail change in India. Then also the customer preference is also changing, and also the finally the development of the internet and access of the reach and access of the TV channels and broadcast media has been entering into the lives of the people. So these are the reasons why the retail change in India is developing. Then from the various retailing concept that has to be kept in mind. Whenever we see about the retail concepts, when you look in the diagram, these are the four retailing concepts. There's the four pillars on which the retailing concept is based, and basing upon the retailing concept, the retailing strategies for framed for any retail organization. When we are saying customer orientation, that means that the customer should remain in the focus and all these activities and actions should be taken keeping the customer in mind. Then comes the coordinated effort. The coordinated effort should be done. All the activities and functions that is carried on by the retailers should be done in such a way so that they're coordinated in such a way that they provide maximum satisfaction to the customer. Then should be value driven, that the retail firm should be value driven. They should try to provide the maximum value to the customer so that the needs and wants of the customer will be satisfied, and the customer will find will give more, get more value when he makes purchases from this particular retail organization. Then the retail concept should be goal oriented. The certain goals that should be set previously before making this retail strategy. So this goal orientation should be done. The goal, all these activities should be done with the accomplishment of goals. So this customer orientation, coordinated effort, value driven goal orientation are the pillars on which the retail concept is based, and basing upon these retail concept that the retail strategy for a retail firm is made. So this is also one of the important questions. Then comes another question that is very, very important, that is the what are the various challenges that is faced by retail in India. There are certain challenges that is faced by India, retailers in India. First is the lack of technology adoption. Technology is not properly adopted in India. Adoption of technology is one of the reasons for slow growth of retail in India sometimes. And then there's lack of infrastructure and logistics. The logistics and infrastructure is not as per the international standards. So that is also one of the challenges they are facing. Then the scarcity of skilled workforce is also a problem, because a lot of workforce are not skilled. So that is the reason that a lot of attrition is also there. So scarcity of skilled workers is also one of the challenges for the retail industry. Then comes the frauds in retail. There's a lot of fraud to those retail shrinkage. A lot of frauds due to picking of these items in the stores due to non-availability of CCTV cameras. So all these things, frauds in retail is also one of the challenges of retail. Then comes insufficient supply chain management. Inefficient supply chain management, the supply chain is not properly managed. This leads to a lot of delay and loss. So this is also one of the challenges for the retail organization. Then comes price war. Sometimes the retail organization enter into price war, thereby the profitability decreases. Then comes the cultural diversity. India is a culturally diverse country where a lot of people are present, and each is the India is such a cultural diverse country, the customer demand changes and is very, very varied. So that is also poses one of the challenges to the retail organization. Then if there is complexity in tax structure, these taxes in India is very, very complex. That is also one major problem for retail development in India. Then comes the escalating land and rental prices. Whenever retail outlet is open, then either it should be on rent or the retailer may decide to buy the property and then open its outlet. In both the cases, this rising, escalating land and rental prices is one of the major prime concerns or challenges for a retail organization. Then comes the competition from unorganized sector. The percentage of unorganized sector in India is more than 94%. Since a large portion of the sector is unorganized, this provides a steep competition to these organized sectors. This is one of the major challenges. Similarly, online selling companies are also posing as a major challenge to the retail companies, because these online companies, they do not have the middlemen and they are able to provide the merchandise to the customer as per their convenience at lower prices. So this proved to be a major challenge to the brick and mortar companies. Then comes the power supply problem in India. The power supply in India is not very, very proper, and sometimes it is not even stable. When a retail organization is operating an outlet, then it has to have a performance largely dependent upon the power supply, because the escalator, air conditioning, cold storing, built system, lifts, everything is controlled by the power. So if this power supply is not proper, then it creates a lot of problem with the retailers. Then there is a high cost of operations, since a lot of things are there, power supply is there, skilled manpower is required, a lot of escalating land prices. This together forms the cost of operation of a retail outlet to be very, very high. This is also one of the major challenges to the retail industry. Then comes the entrance of global retail jets. Due to this development and of FDI in India, since 100% FDI given in single brand and 51% FDI is possible in multi-brand retail, a large retail giants are entering into retail. This is posing a problem and challenge to the retail, this Indian-based retail organization. Then comes the changing consumer preference. The changing consumer preference is also one of the major problems, because the cultural diversity in India, and the people have different preferences towards different merchandise. This causes one of the major challenges to the retail development in India. Then comes the, we should understand what are the opportunities in India. Why Indian retailing? In India, retailing is very, very important. Indian retail accounts for more than 10% of the country's GDP, and around 8% of the employment is generated by the retail. That is the reason why retailing is very, very important. Finally, what are the major opportunities? The rising income, the growing population, the availability of infrastructure. These are some of the reasons. Then willingness and eagerness to spend money. People are more interested to spend money nowadays, the young people. Then the urbanization of rural cities. That means the retail organization can enter into rural areas. Then in the internet revolution and social and cultural changes due to this internet revolution. People are having these handheld devices, having internet, and then also the reach of TV channels has increased into rural areas, thereby increasing the opportunities for retail development. There is social and cultural changes. The women are working, the education, the demands of the people are changing. So the social and cultural changes also is one of the opportunities, is conducive for the retail organizations. Then the customer retail bond. Customer retailer, they have a bond. That is also the brand consciousness also increased. People are more conscious towards big brands of foreign brands like Sony, Samsung, Xiaomi, Panasonic. So this is the reason that is a tremendous chance of retail growth in India. Then also the English speaking brigade of youth. People are nowadays are speaking, youths are speaking in English. So that means their organization can be improved very easily. Nuclear family is also one of the reasons why there is opportunity for retail growth in India, because nowadays a lot of other products and services are needed because people are living in nuclear families. Similarly, the increasing the number of working women is also one of the reasons, because whenever the women are working, they do not have time to make purchases. So they want to find a one-stop solution where they can make their retail purchases. So that is the reason why the organized retail, there is a scope for organized retail in India. Then entering of the foreign retailers has also gained a lot of advantages, because the foreign retailers, when they are entering, then the competition is increasing. The new and improved variety of retail outlets are coming into picture. Similarly, the consumerism is also one of the reasons. People are highly knowledgeable about what are the products and the quality of the products they are going to buy. So since this there is a rise in consumerism, this also is one of the opportunities why the retail development can grow in India very fast. So apart from that, we should understand what are the various retail sectors in India. We will try to focus on certain key retail sectors. First is the food sector that we can see. Then food is separately divided into food and grocery, then food services. And again, the food and grocery is divided into fresh and dry groceries, branded packaged foods, hygiene products. Similarly, the food services divided into catering services, restaurants, and fast food sectors. Similarly, when we take into account the consumer durable industry, the retail industry sector, then we have two types. Again, this consumer electronics and the consumer utilities. Consumer electronics are again divided into televisions, home theaters, audio systems, DVD and VCD systems. And then these utilities are consisting of washing machines, kitchen appliances, vacuum cleaners, air conditioners, and refrigerators. So in this way, the consumer durable retail sector is also being divided. Then comes the apparel industry. The apparel industry, again, the apparel industry divided into men's, women's wear, children's wear, and then the formal wear into formal, casual, and accessories for all the three. So this is also where the retail sector, apparel retail sector is divided. Similarly, the footwear sector is divided into shoes, boots, overshoes, and slippers and rubbers. So these are the way these sectors, retail sectors has been designed. Then comes the structure of Indian retail, retail structure. The Indian retail structure was having a business, pegged a business of 950 billion in 2018 and holds a slot of the five major retail markets in the world, and by 2020 it is believed to be 1.1 trillion. So whenever we say about the retail, Indian retail sector, there are two major sectors that has come to the focus. One is the unorganized sector and the organized sector. It is generally found that 95.4% of the sector is unorganized sector. This means the small pan bidi outlets, general stores, kirana stores, or mom and pop stores that have been present everywhere in India. So these are known as the unorganized sector, and they constitute the larger part of the retail sector. Then comes the unorganized part. Then comes the organized part. This is only hardly 4.6%, and that is the reason the organized retailing is not very, very famous in India. But these retail organized retailing is growing day by day, because the opportunities of retail in India, growth of retail in India is growing day by day. So the organized sector is growing, organized retail is growing day by day. Now we have to understand certain formats of retail, both organized and unorganized. In unorganized format, there are the mandis, haats, melas, and then local kirana or paniya shops. These are the various formats that are present in the unorganized sector. These are prevalent, found in India, and they are still found in India. So these are from the part of the unorganized sector. Then the organized sector is divided into three parts: store-based, non-store-based, and service-based. The organized sector, most of the customers come from the organized sector, so it's one of them. It is very important to understand this organized sector formats. If we see the store based, they can divide into two types: ownership based and merchandise based. Ownership based is again divided into independent retailers, chain retailers, franchises, and consumer cooperative stores. And then merchandise based, so depending upon the merchandise, when it is divided, the retail outlets are divided, then it is the various merchandise base. Then this convenience stores, supermarkets, hypermarkets, specialty stores, department stores, factory outlet, catalog, showroom. So these are the ways in which, based upon the merchandise, their various retail formats have been designed. And apart from the store based retail format, there is a non-store based retail format. That means no store is required for having these kind of retail formats, that is direct sales, email order, postal orders, telemarketing, and automated vending. Apart from that, service-based retail formats are also present. Various service-based providers like banks, car rentals, service contracts are examples of service-based retail formats in India. So if you go through this, all the headings, we can see independent retailers are small retailers. They operate in a family basis. They are mainly managed by the families. They do not have much lobbying power. Then come the chain stores. These chain stores are generally corporate based or some also individual owned. So what happens in that, a lot of 2 to 3 shops are opened under a particular brand. There is centralized brand, so they have a lot of lobbying power. Then comes the franchises. Franchises is very, very important to understand, because there is a contractual agreement between the buyer and between the franchisor and the franchisee, where the franchisee is allowed to sell the items of the franchisor as per the rules and regulations of the franchisor, as per the rules and regulations laid down in the franchise agreement. Then comes the cooperative stores. Cooperative stores are very, very important. These stores are generally opened because these stores are aimed at providing the merchandise to the customers at low rates. Since the consumers, they are member of these cooperative stores, they contribute together the money, and they together buy huge quantities of merchandise, and then they purchase from these cooperative stores. So these cooperative stores are managed by these consumers. So these are the ownership based ownership-based retail formats: independent retailers, chain retailers, franchising. Franchising is again of two types: product-based franchising or business franchising, product or trademark franchising. The franchisee has certain autonomy and about like what is the store operation hours, what is the location, what is the way you can have display. Example of the gas stations, these are generally product or trademark format. And when it comes to business format, the whole business format is given as a franchise, and the franchisor has the complete authority about control upon the all the operations of selling, inventory, accounting, personnel process, all are controlled by the franchisor. Examples is Pizza Hut. Apart from that, in a store-based in this ownership base, there is also lease departments, where a particular department of department, these are also known as shopping stores. A particular department of a large departmental store is leased out to the general lease department. This consumer cooperative, we have also discussed. These are the major ownership based retail format. Then comes to the classification based on merchandise offer. First is the convenience store. These are small stores near residential areas. These are mainly done to provide this merchandise to the people, and the small stores Then comes the supermarkets. Supermarkets are very large stores. These are characterized by low cost, low margin, high volume, self-service market that is designed for both food and non-food items. And as per the needs of the consumer, the supermarkets are present. Then comes the hypermarkets. Hypermarket is derived from the French word hypermarché, which means a combination of supermarket and a departmental store. They are bigger in size than the supermarket and they provide a lot of items to the merchandise to the consumer. Then come the specialty. So specialty store is one which focuses upon one or two particular categories, and then they have very narrow product line but deep product depth. These are my specialty stores like Proline Fitness, Gautier Furniture. So whenever we are speaking about Proline Fitness outlets, they are completely, they have a very narrow product line of fitness products and fitness equipments, and they have a very great depth of product. So that is also, you know, this is known as a specialty store. Then comes department store. Department store is a generally large-scale outlet which is multi-level, and with a very the whole store is divided into various departments like clothing, accessories, cosmetics, households, etc. So these are known as a department store. Department stores are very famous. Famous department stores are Shoppers Stop, Globus, Macy's, Westside, Lifestyle. The other these are department stores. Then comes the factory outlet. Factory outlets are places where little outlet that sells discounted items which are generally irregular, outdated, or have been produced in excess quantity. These are generally present near the, also known as factory shop, are present near the factory, and the merchandise is provided at a very cheap rate. That is the one of the characteristics of this factory outlet. Then comes the catalog showrooms. In catalog showrooms, the consumer do not need to go to the showroom. All the items are not displayed in the showroom, and the consumer just need to go to the showroom and then, depending upon the catalog, looking into the catalog, just place the order for the various items he wants, and those items will be delivered at the doorstep of the consumer. Then comes the discount store. Discount store, as the name suggests, is the where price is the very important. Here, deep discounts are provided for purchasing of merchandise that are in large quantities. So examples like Walmart, Kmart, Best Buy, Target, these are all the Loot in India that is present. These are the major discount stores in India that are, or abroad that is present. Then come the exclusive stores. As the name suggests, exclusive stores are the consist the product of a merchandise of a particular single brand. So the major advantage of exclusive store is that all the latest designs items are first coming to the exclusive store and then going to other stores. So major exclusive stores like Amazon, Samsung, Peter England, this LG, they have a exclusive stores in India. Then comes destination store. Destination store is nothing but the first thing that comes to your mind when a person wants to buy something, that is known as a destination store. As destination stores is a has a huge assortment of materials and merchandise, and the people, since they know that if they go to the destination store, they can get whatever design, color and variety of the merchandise they want, they are interested even to take long tours in order to reach these destination stores. Like if you find certain stores, the book market in Daryaganj, Delhi, or for book lovers, then Nehru Place, Delhi, that is for gadget lovers. So these are all known as destination stores where people come from various places in order to purchase from these stores. Then comes the non-store retailing, non-store-based retailing, where the store is not required. First is direct sales. Direct sales can be one-to-one or one-to-many, maybe party method, and then also multi-level marketing can be done where there is a direct front-to-front meeting of the people and the goods are being sold. Then comes telemarketing, where telephone devices, telecommunications, telephone, fax, internet is used to make calls to the people, and those people who are interested, then those people are being provided with the particular products. Then comes direct marketing. Under direct marketing, it is seen that whenever we are contacting customers through broadcasting or print media, who in turn buy products without visiting the store, this is known as direct marketing. In direct marketing, there are three major types. First is direct mail marketing, where mail is directly sent to the customers. Then comes the catalog marketing, where people are provided with catalogs, and then depending upon the catalogs, they make purchases. Then comes televised shopping, where small infomercials are given, maybe for 30 seconds, 60 seconds, or sometimes there are very telebrands or Times Shopping India. These are complete channel dedicated to televised shopping. So there are various slots of 30 minutes and 60 minutes where a particular item or particular merchandise of a particular company is being shown, and there are people who have used the product. They showcase what are the features and the benefits of the particular product. Then comes the automated vending. Automated vending is very famous in India nowadays, becoming famous because here machines, they interact with the customers, and the machines, they provide with all the merchandise to the customer. Generally, chocolate snacks things are generally used to provide it to the customers by using these automated vending machines. Previously, these automated vending machines were very, very difficult to man, but today, due to the advent of technology and advancement of this CCTVs and other thing, the automated vending is increasing day by day. Then comes the electronic retailing. This is a part of the e-commerce where the or online retailing where people generally sit at the home and from their convenience of their home without visiting the store, they can make purchases as per the needs and requirements of the customers, like Alibaba, Amazon, Flipkart, eBay, Tata Click are some of the major electronic retailing companies in India. Then comes information kiosk. Information kiosk is nothing but a small freestanding physical structure that displays information or provides service to a particular customers. These are generally found in airports, railways, libraries. So the nothing but a kiosk is nothing but a computer terminal housed inside a particular housed inside a machine and has a touch screen on the outside that provides information to the people about a particular product, about their particular company, or provides certain services to the customers. So this is another information kiosk. So these are the various non-store based retailing that is found in India. Non-store based retailing format found in India. Then comes service based retailing, as we have discussed, car retailing, retail banking, car rentals, various forms of electricity, gas, service contracts. These are the various ways in which retailing formats are present in the retail formats are present in the service. And then comes the emerging retail format. So these are the retail format. These are still growing in India and they have a huge scope in India. First is a van or mobile retailing where vans are used in order to provide the merchandise at the doorstep of the people. Either it may be placed in a public place that is known as static retailing, or it may be raving retailing where the van moves throughout the rural areas and provides from this merchandise to the people, customers, directly at that doorstep. Then there is conference or party or event retailing where a party or conference or event is done and where they show that they demonstrate the merchandise and then they are finally sold. Then comes distant retailing. This is a form of non-store based retailing where people from a distance without visiting the shops, they can go and purchase, can order this merchandise and that can be delivered to that doorstep. Then comes forecourt retailing where generally in high traffic areas or high building, big buildings, these retail outlets are open. Generally, there is a like Vishal Mega Mart has tied up with HPCL for opening their Vishal Corner Mart. So this kind is known as store forecourt retailing. Then comes state park retailing. State park retailing generally means state parks are set up from metro cities or big cities from where people can purchase. Generally international customers or exporters can purchase from this kind of the areas. Generally big trade parks are examples of big trade parks are like exposition mart that is set up in by the handicapped and export promotion council that is in Greater Noida. Similarly, the international home deco park that is present in Greater Noida, some of the trade parks. Also another format of retailing that is emerging in India is airport retailing, whereby small outlets are opened for cosmetics and other things are opened in these outlets and people in these airports and people those who are traveling in the by using this through this via aeroplane, they have to visit the airport and these shops are present in the airport and this customer, they are like a captive audience to whom they can sell. So airport retailing is also gaining a lot of importance and eminence in recent times. Similarly, cash and carry outlets are also increasing day by day. Cash and carry means this is a form of where format where the merchandise is generally sold not to the consumers but all the final consumers as per the definition of the retail, but generally sold to the wholesalers, warehouse or distributors, those who buy in bulk quantities, and these are only sold to those wholesaler, warehouse, distributors, those who are registered with these cash and carry outlets. The major advantage is the major reason why it is known as cash and carry, because the people, those are these middlemen, those are buying from this cash and carry outlet, they have to pay in cash and they are responsible to carry their merchandise to their own place. Walmart and Bharati are making a similar, Tesco and Trent are also coming up with cash and carry formats. So these are the various formats that is emerging formats available in India. So this is the recap of all the topics that we have studied in unit